CSS also supports background images, and this feature can be used to achieve a number of responsive effects. You can use CSS to add a background pattern to an element or the page itself. And you can combine that with gradients and other CSS effects. It's possible to get some incredible effects with pure CSS. Check out the examples on the website linked to below the video. With the background size cover property, CSS can also be used to add a background image that resizes without squashing or stretching. And again, this can be really handy for using images when you don't know the size of the viewport. The details in a photo can get lost when it's shrunk, so this example displays the whole image if the viewport is more than 500 pixels wide, or a smaller crop otherwise. I've added a CSS transition so there's not too much of a jolt if you resize the window. You'll see that from the dev tools, the smaller koala crop is displayed, downloaded when the window is small, and then if you resize the window larger, the larger crop is downloaded and displayed. CSS background images can be used for conditional display of images, depending on viewport size, using CSS like this. As you can see from the dev tools, the background image file is not downloaded if the viewport width is less than 500 pixels. Now, you'll find out more about media queries later, and a much less hacky and much more efficient way to accomplish alternative image loading when we look at the source set attribute and the picture element in Lesson 3. With background images, you can also use the CSS image set function to choose a background image depending on screen resolution. This example displays a 2x color image on a high resolution display like my phone, and a 1x monochrome image otherwise. For the devices that don't support image set, the CSS falls back to the 1x version. If you check the dev tools, you'll see that only the appropriate image is downloaded. You'll learn a lot more about responding to screen resolution in Lesson 3.